स्टूडेंट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट चैप्टर 10 क्लास 5 टॉपिक द ब्लाइंड वुमन एंड द फिजिशियन. सो हियर इज अ समरी ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. लॉन्ग लॉन्ग एगो इन अ स्मॉल टाउन इन इंग्लैंड दिस स्टोरी वॉज अबाउट इन इंग्लैंड वॉट हैपेंड लेट्स सी इन दिस समरी. देयर वॉज अ वेरी रिच ओल्ड वुमन. मतलब वंस अपॉन अ टाइम देयर लिव्ड अ old woman who is very rich named Mrs. Humphrey. Over the years she had lost her eyesight means she gone blind. She lived all alone in a large house in the country side. She had many position and no heirs means no any children to survive their livelihood. And let's see the rest of the summary. When she was 40 years ago she noticed that her eyesight was deteriorating day by day, means reducing her eyesight day by day. Her neighbor visited her gradually with all kinds of advice. Some said some said this and some said that. Now in her town there was a very renowned physician by the name of Dr. White. After consulting her friend, she decided to call him to her house and get his expert opinion and advice. So she called him up and said, Dr. White, I have heard so much about you. You will will you please come to my home and see what you can do about my blindness. Dr. White threw a very very good ophthalmologist was not the kind of person the people thought him to be. As soon as he was giving the offer to go to Mrs. Humphrey's residence to treat her, his mind started working. Dr. White rapidly agreed to go to Mrs. Humphrey Palatial home means a very large home. Palatial means a very large home. And conduct a thorough checkup on her eyes. After many tests, he got to the root of her problems and assured her that he would cure her blindness within 3 months. Means doctor promised he will definitely cure within 3 days of his eyesight. However, he was a very greedy person and did not live up to the norms of his noble positions. Norms means a standard set for a certain group of people. He laid down a condition, and the rich Mrs. Humphrey agreed to the condition that was read that was read out in the presence of witnesses. The condition was if I, Dr. White, succeed in curing Mrs. Humphrey of her blindness in three months, I will receive from Mrs. Humphrey a sum of $500. But if she is not cured, Mrs. Humphrey owns me nothing. The agreement was signed, and the specialist started his statement. Mr. White would visit Mrs. Humphrey twice a day in her to treat her. He would apply an ointment ointment in her eyes. Then he would bandage her eyes, give her a tablet and tell to her rest. As soon as he was sure that Mrs. Humphrey was fast asleep on every visit, Dr. White would take something from her house and carry it away to his house. Means doctor was a thief also, who stolen anything from her house. Little by little he stole her all her household possessions. Mrs. Humphrey was ignorant of this fact. Means 3 months passed by, and finally the day came when Dr. White was to remove all her bandages and prove that his treatment had cured her. He came to Mrs. Humphrey's grand residence and walked into her parlor like a cut that had licked up all the cream. All her friends who had been there the day the agreement was signed were gathered around her. Dr. White removed the bandage, being sure that Mrs. Humphrey was now able to see clearly. He demanded his promised payment. Mrs. Humphrey, however, on recovering her sight, was shocked to see that that all her household valuable goods were gone. Where is her valuable things gone? So she refused to pay him. Mrs. White, instead of his calm claim, and when she refused to lost no time in summoning her before the judge. Mrs. Humphrey stood up in the court and said, "My lord, Mr. White is speaking the truth. I did promise to give him a sum of $500 if I recovered my sight, but if I continued to be blind, I would owe him nothing now. He declared in the presence of all that I am cured. On the contrary, I confirm to all of you here that I am still blind. For before I lost the sight of my eyes, I could see and took pride in showing other the valuable I possessed. But now, though Dr. White swear he has cured me, I am not able to see a single valuable household item around me." So here is the last paragraph of this chapter, student. Listen carefully. Mrs. Humphrey lodged an FIR immediately, stating that she suspected Dr. White of the thief, as no one except Dr. White has access to her possessions, as he was the only person who had ever entered her house since she turned blind. An inquiry was set up, and very soon the truth was revealed. All the valuables were found in Dr. White's house. Mr. Humphrey won the case and got back all her stolen goods and was also free of her blindness. He was accused of theft and sentenced to a term of imprisonment. So I hope you all understand by this chapter. So what is the moral of this lesson? Moral is that no trust anyone. Factfully, no trust anyone. So you have trust, then you will pay a very large amount of trust. So thank you.